is going on, everybody? How is everybody doing today? Welcome back here today to the second installment of the GOAT Race series. And today, we are using and tracking the career of Zion Williamson. Thank you to everybody that showed support on the first installment of the Giannis Antetokounmpo career sim. Zion has a lot to live up to today if he wants to end up with a better career than Giannis. He's currently gonna start it on the injury report, but only for 1 to 2 weeks. And we all know how great Zion is in the simulation. So we're gonna have even more years than Giannis because Giannis's career started around, I think, 26, 27 for us. He's 21. We might have almost 20 years left of Zion's career. He's off to a great start. And like the last episode, we have auto-generated rookies. So unlike the Giannis installment, I'm going to use a 2022 and 2023 draft class that is real and accurate just because I want to see if Zion could ever pair up with Chad Holmgren or Imani Bates just for this one. And if I like it better with auto-generated, we'll go back to that for the third installment. But like the Giannis episode, we are going to only interfere if this is just going to absolute shit and Zion will not even sniff the GOAT conversation. But 2K loves Zion Williamson, so I think we'll be okay. So we'll start off season number one. We'll see how this goes. Trade, scouting, free agency, it's all on automated, or it's all auto right now. And then if we have to step in, it won't be. So I'll see you guys at the end of the 2022 season. And look, Zion's basically back already. I also noticed with Zion Williamson's career that he tends to switch teams sometimes. So I'm hoping I see that. Maybe a big switch, that big decision today that we didn't see in the Giannis career sim. So we're finishing up the 2022 season, and you can see, yeah, the Zion effect is already happening as we are the one seed. So I don't think we're gonna have to worry about team success today. Giannis takes home MVP. I'm hoping we get multiple out of Zion today. Cade Cunningham's your rookie of the year. Drummond, sixth man. Giannis, DPOY. So no awards for Zion. He doesn't even get an All-NBA team this year. Okay, that's going to hurt a little bit. We will definitely need to get that up. So I also want to take a look to see if any trades were made with this Pelicans roster throughout the year. It looks like nothing really. So we can see that in Zion's third season in the NBA. He averaged 27 points, 7.8 rebounds, about 4 assists, 69% from the field. Yeah, I don't think he's going to be a big three-point shooter for us, so we won't look at any three-point records for Zion throughout this. So let's see what happens in the 2022 playoffs. Can the Pelicans just ball out, sweep the Jazz? They beat the Clippers in 7, beat the Warriors, and oh my god, no! No! Off to a terrible start. Oh, man. I mean, not a terrible start, but you just blew a 3-1 lead. It was 1-0, 2-0. It was a 3-0 lead! Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, well, we might have a LeBron career here. We're 0-1 in the finals now. All right, so we could see who retires. We could see the league meetings. Max length of a contract is 3 years. Sure, I mean, a lot of owners want that, so we'll switch that, and we are not eliminating the goaltending rule. I feel like that would just be really bad. So let's advance here to the next season. We'll take a look at the team and what it's looking like. We'll see who they possibly drafted. We'll see if they traded for anybody, if they signed anyone. I think Zion was also due a new contract extension, or no, that will be next year, so that will happen. All right, so let's take a look here at the rotation. It's Devontae Graham, Naw, Ingram, Zion, Jonas Valanciunas. Oof, they've added Benedict Mathurin. I don't think that's going to change much, but we just went to the finals, so it is okay. But damn, that hurts a little bit. I was hoping for a big new addition. So we'll see what happens here in the 2023 season, and let's hope it ends up with us winning the last game of the year. We end the season as the one seed here in the Western Conference. That's what I'm talking about, but Zion does not take home any awards. I mean, Luke is putting up 35, 10, and 10. Yeah, he's going to be MVP. I am excited to do the Luka career sim as well, and we'll see if he can become the GOAT. But let's go back to Zion. Does he get an All-NBA team? He's going to have to start getting these. None? Oh my goodness, Zion. Oh my goodness. One seed might not matter. I mean, okay. We want to see the accolades. Oh my god, no! Damn it. It's happened a couple times in Giannis's career sim, but Zion dislocates his left patella out for the season. So he's not even in the playoffs. He only played in 57 games. That's the injury prone Zion for you. It's going to be tough to make him the GOAT, but he's still incredibly young. And they're going to lose in round one because of that. I mean, I'm not surprised that the Thunder pull off the upset, but that's 2 years in, 0 championships. At least Zion is only, what, like 23 years old still? All right, so Dwight Howard heads to the Hall of Fame. Cool. Jersey retirements, Lowry and Dwight, league meetings. sure, we can have that occur a week earlier. And let's advance here to the next season. All right, so does the team look any different? And let's hope Zion is ready to go. He is. So they added Keontae George in the draft. So they've had Keontae George. Benedict Mathurin is going to be down on the rotation. But they haven't really added anybody else. We know that Zion is going to be under a new contract now with the Pelicans. He will be here for the next four seasons, not the hotel. And yeah, we'll see what they can do. Hopefully Zion is healthy for the playoffs. And yeah, let's, I don't know, no center play. I might have to step in if they're not going to do anything to this team. All right, so we ended up as the two seed. No MVP for Zion once again. All right, we'll take a look. He does get All-NBA second team, though, and he puts up a career-high 29.8 points and 11.1 rebounds and a career-high in assists as well, career-high in field goal percentage, and a career-high in free throw percentage. Damn, how are those not MVP numbers? We are the two seed, and did they make any moves this year? They did. Is that Keldon Johnson? They traded for Keldon Johnson. Okay, that's something. Benedict Mathurin, their 27th overall pick, is out of the rotation. Keontae George was number five. That could be from the Bucks or from the Lakers. If we take a look, we could see, where's this Pelicans trade at? Are you just not gonna show me it, or am I just completely missing it? I don't know. I don't see any Pelicans trade, so I have no idea who was traded for Keldon Johnson, unless he was a free agent, which could have happened. I also want to turn off the lottery automation, because I kind of want to see that. So can Zion prevail, and have a good playoff run, or they could lose in round one to the Warriors? They are in the conference finals, in the NBA finals, and let's go! Zion's legacy has started as the New Orleans Pelicans are your 2024 NBA champions. And Zion is your finals MVP after they swept the Hawks, who were the reigning NBA champions. Wow, that's a season and a half for Zion. That is going to start off his legacy already with an NBA Finals MVP under his belt at 23. Having those numbers in the playoffs, that's great for the legacy. So I did put some of these things back that I could see them. They're still automated. And you know what? I'm not going to make any moves. The Pelicans just won it all. I will not step in. We're just going to keep watching. We're going to reject all of these. I do want to see the draft lottery because I wonder if they have any random Bucks or Lakers picks throughout these next couple of years. Look at that at pick three. So it's looking like the Pelicans are also going to be picking at number three, number 18, and number 30 after just winning the NBA Finals. So this is the first year of auto-generated draft classes. So we'll see who they're going to end up selecting. And they ended up with Art Webb, a center at the third overall pick. They got Pete King, a power forward at number 18. Very short first and last names. Mario De Luca, he's going to be overseas for a year. And then Guy Taylor, I'll sign that for them. Why not? Qualifying offers, give it to Herbert Jones, give it to Kyra Lewis. So we'll see if they do anything in free agency. I think I like looking at this better than just kind of simulating it. So looks like they're letting Kyra walk, Billy Hernan Gomez. Nah is going to walk as well. Okay. Nope, they do re-sign Kyra. They sign Matisse Thybul. Also, that is a new signing for them. They also go out and sign Hassan Whiteside. And then here is player progression. They still have Brandon Ingram, who has 1 year left on his deal. I wonder if they would explore trading him. They did get Gnaw back, it looks like, on a two-year deal worth around $21 million. All right, so the start of the third season. We got Kyra Lewis, Nickeil Alexander-Walker, Brandon Ingram, Zion Williamson, Whiteside with Keontae George, Devontae Graham, Trey Murphy, Matisse Thybul, and Herbert Jones off the bench. So they're not even playing Art Webb. It was the third overall pick. All right, we'll see if that is a questionable decision. I do want to check out system proficiency. Haven't done that yet. Four-star balance under Chester James. That's who you hired as your head coach. All right, his ratings don't look very good. All right, so we end the season as the one seed, but Zion does not take home an MVP award. Come on, LaMelo. You can't keep winning it every year. We gotta cross your fingers. A virtual LaMelo ball gets hurt, like, every year. So Zion takes home his first All-NBA first team. We need that to be a constant trend throughout these. Is he gonna get any all-defensive teams? No, it doesn't look like it, which is fine, but I thought he'd maybe progress into being a really good defender. We can see that Zion averaged 28 and 12. There's Brandon Ingram. Trey Murphy is currently out 4 to 6 weeks, and Kyra Lewis is out for the season with a spinal injury. So we'll take a look at what the new rotation is going to look like for the playoffs. Zion's getting 39 minutes a night. You love to see that. And we'll see if he can carry the Pelicans to their second championship in this video. They sweep the Mavericks. They sweep the Grizzlies, they beat the Nuggets in five, and then they beat the Pistons in five. And Zion Williamson now has two finals MVPs at 24 years old. 24! That is very good. He is 2-1 in his career in the NBA Finals. Should be 3-0 with three finals MVPs. It is draft lottery time. Do we have another random pick here in the lottery? And we do not. The Pelicans are going to have pick 30 and pick 22 via Milwaukee. In the draft, they did end up drafting Kenneth Maggette. Don't know if he's related to Corey. Calbert Tinsley. Don't know if he's related to Jamal. Jimmy Morrison, and then Mario DeLuca for coming up overseas from last year's season. So Trey Murphy, Herb Jones, Mark Mitchell, they have, are all getting the qualifying offers. We'll see if they make any big splashes in free agency. They bring back Kyra Lewis on a three-year deal, but I thought they got him back on a multi-year contract last year. They bring in Shake Milton as well. Matisse Thybulle, they re-signed him. So I'm not going to step in and make any moves. They get Mo Wagner. I mean, they're winning championships. I'm only stepping in if the team is not looking good and they're in the gutter. So yeah, not going to step in and make any moves. And we will now advance here to, I believe, the fifth season. No, I'm dumb. This is the fourth season. Zion's a 96. All right, so we take a look at the team. Zion Williamson is a 96 overall, getting 37 minutes a night. It's Lewis, George, Ingram, Williamson, Webb. About time they're starting Keontae George. They have Mark Mitchell off the bench. They got Naw, Thybulle, and then Pete King. So we'll see how this team does. System proficiency is going to be 3-star triangle under Alton Atkins. Can we maybe get some new coaching here, please? All right, so we end the season as the 2 seed in the Western Conference. Well, LaMelo Ball is stealing all these MVP awards. Damn, I really need them to sign like a Giannis. So, or like somebody else at the 25 point per game score. So his output goes down. Zion does get another All-NBA first team. As we are the 2 seed here in the Western Conference, we'll take a look at the rotation. Is anybody, I don't know if anybody's hurt at the moment, but Zion's going to be getting 41 minutes for the playoffs. That is some big time numbers. It doesn't look like anybody is hurt. Matisse, now just a morale downgrade. So taking a look here at the player stats, this was Zion throughout the season, 26.5 points, 11 rebounds, 4.2 assists, 68% from the field, a 97 overall. Can he win 3 straight finals MVPs? Yes, win in 5. Beat the Rockets? Yes. Oh, man. Zion is now 2-2 in the finals. Damn. The Cavs beat us. Paolo Banchero is your finals MVP. I mean, they'd have Sexland, Banchero, Mobley, Allen. That's filthy. Okoro, Davion. Oh, no. Dylan Mitchell. Okay, I was going to say, holy crap, that team's sick. They brought Tristan Thompson back. Damn, Zion is 2-2 in the finals. What did LeBron start off at? He was 2-2, right? No, he started off, I think, yeah, because he lost to San Antonio, he lost to Dallas, so he was 0-2, and then ended up becoming 2-2 after beating OKC and San Antonio. So, kind of has that LeBron career trajectory at the moment with his finals. That just sucks, man. Really does. DeRozan retires for the Bulls. Draymond on the Warriors. Paul George heads to the Hall of Fame. Draymond gets his jersey retired. So let's not increase the shot clock to 45 seconds. Hell no. We can change the defensive key violations. And then the top teams from each conference. No, I don't really want that. So let's go here to the draft lottery. Any random picks for the Pelicans? Nope, not in the lottery, but they do have the 17th pick from the Bucks. So Kevin Moore is a 75 overall, 17th overall pick out of Virginia Tech. And then we have 2 second round picks. I'll sign them. Qualifying offers, Mark Mitchell and Benedict Mathurin are getting them. And then I also just wanted to double check, did Zion get a new contract? Nope, he has 1 year left on his deal. Could he be an unrestricted free agent next year? Possibly. Gotta keep an eye on that. So let's see, do we sign anybody throughout the offseason? Do we make a big splash? I know Ingram is a free agent, correct? I don't know. I'll have to take a look. Maybe we re-signed him actually, so... We do sign Victor Oladipo to a 2-year contract. It looks like Ingram did come back on a 2-year deal. All right, Oladipo, he is 34 years old, so that could be a risky signing. They brought back Matisse Thybulle. Don't really know why, since he was out of the rotation and very unhappy with his role here in New Orleans. They got Jericho Sims, Chris Dunn, and Mamadi Diakite, and that looks like it's it for the offseason. So take a look at player progression. Zion's still a 96. Just want to go back to the finals, but hopefully going to win it. So we take a look at the rotation this year. Zion will be getting 37 minutes a night. You got Art Webb, who's now up to an 83 overall for the Pelicans. He's had a really good sophomore year. You got Ingram, Keontae George, who's also really good. Kyra Lewis, how's he doing facilitating? 6.6 assists, but that efficiency, not great at all. You got Thybulle. You got Pete King. How's he been? Nothing special. You got Oladipo as the sixth man. Benedict Mathurin hasn't really been much. He has just been going on a downward spiral since his rookie season. And we'll see what happens at the end of the 2027 year. All right, what the hell? Caleb Houston wins MVP. So this is the year. Okay, you're wondering why we're the 11th seed. Zion tore his Achilles in the beginning of the year. Missed basically the whole season, which freaking sucks. But yeah, Caleb Houston wins MVP this year. I have never seen that. Cool to see. I don't even think Zion's going to get an All-NBA team. I don't think he really met the game requirements. Yeah. He might be fully healthy now. Nope, he's still out for 6 to 8 weeks. Damn, like that hurts. These are the numbers he was putting up. How many games did he end up playing before he got hurt? He played in 39 games. Here's his right Achilles. And he did get a new contract extension from the Pelicans, it looks like. So he will be here for the next 3 seasons. And the Cavs win it all. Paolo Banchero is your Finals MVP. He's having arguably a better career than Zion is. Oh, that's just brutal, man. Zion's had multiple season-ending injuries in this video. The Pelicans have just their pick, and that ended up being 10. So we'll see if they get a good rookie with that. Sebastian Jeffries, though, is a 77 overall. He looks pretty good. And we got Casey Carroll in the second round. Qualifying offers, Keontae George. Hopefully they re-sign him because he's pretty good. And then we'll just take a look here at free agency. Does anything get done? Nothing so far on day one. Nothing on day two. Benedict Mathurin's also a free agent. So they work out a massive 4-year extension for Keontae George. Wow, he got paid a lot of money, over $30 million a year, but he is pretty good. So they bring back Sabin Lee. They also, doesn't look like they're making any immediate moves. So yeah, I think that is going to be it basically for this offseason. That is just major moves, unless they made a trade. They could have done that, but I believe Brandon Ingram is still here. He has 1 year left on his deal. Zion is not down to a 92 after that Achilles injury. Oh no. He has definitely been injury prone throughout his career. So this is their rotation. Zion will be getting 37 minutes a night as a 92 overall straight off the injury. The bench looking pretty weak. Do we even have a big? Oh, Kevin Moore is our big off the bench, okay. Do we maybe have a good coach for once? I might have to step in and get a good coach. Jeff Vincent, D+, and D, and he runs the triangle. Oh, geez, this would be a full 4-star balance team. I think I need to get a new coach in the offseason. All right, some big news. We were the 11th seed, and I'm pretty sure Zion played the whole season. Not good. I might need to step in. I think I might have to this offseason. We'll see, though. I don't know what to do. I don't think I want to... Like, I kind of want to see Zion on a new team, but I don't know. We could just advance here. I did get a new coach. It's some GM. It's actually a female coach. Can I look at her right now? I can. I have really good ratings. Brianne James. Don't know if there's any relation to LeBron, but yeah, this has basically got a whole new coaching staff, and I'm just hoping that will change some things because having Fred Vincent just a triangle coach for this team was just making my head hurt. And the NBA Finals is going to go to the Portland Trailblazers. Zion Cruz is your Finals MVP. Do they still have Lillard? They do not. Keldon Johnson? No, it's Keon there. Wow, kind of surprising that team won it all. A lot of big names retiring this year, and Steph, Kawhi, and Jimmy Butler head to the Hall of Fame. Can take a league meetings. Top teams from each conference are seated now. Wait, based on record? Yeah, that's fine. Opposing teams won to the bonus of 3 team fouls. That's also fine with me. Draft lottery, anything out of the ordinary. We are supposed to be at pick 12, and we get pick 12. All right, so with the 12th overall pick, the Pelicans took Sam Vaughn, a 77 overall center out of Ohio State. Got Kelly Willis in the second round. Qualifying offers, do want to bring back Art Webb. So do we look at a Zion trade? I don't know. Like, I would obviously take control over a new team. He does have a no trade clause, but it looks like he would be waiving it. Like, is he happy here? Does he want to trade? I'm really curious to see what I'm worth out on the open market once my current deal is over. All right, so we won't look to trade time, but then again, Brandon Ingram is gone. Like, I don't know what move to make here. So let me start up free agency. Do they bring back Brandon Ingram? If not, we'll have to figure it out. They bring in Jonathan Isaac? Okay, they do bring back Brandon Ingram. Do they also get Brandon Clark as well? Were they able to sign all those guys? No, they weren't. They were only able to do that just because they didn't fully bring back Ingram. So they bring in Miles McBride. I mean, like, we could try a sign and trade with Brandon Ingram, say it's time to break this duo up. But no, I think I'm going to give it one more year before we make any moves, because next year, you know what, if we're like the 11th seed again, I may look to trade Zion. So player progression, we have Zion, Ingram, George is the big three. They didn't bring back Art Webb. Are you kidding me? Former third overall pick. All right. Questionable decision to say the least. So we are advancing here to the 2029 season. The team is going to look like Saben Lee, Keyonte George, Brandon Ingram, Zion Williamson, Kevin Moore. And then off the bench, you have Sebastian Jeffrey, Sam Vaughn, Kelly Oubre, and Brandon Clark is here. Okay, they also signed Trey Jones, and we'll see how this team goes about the 2029 season. So LaMelo Ball is an LA Clipper, and he wins the MVP award. I don't know how many that is, but it's got to be a lot at this rate. That is his, only third. I mean, that is a lot, but Zion still has zero. We were the eighth seed. Not great at all. Does he take home an All-NBA second team? No, he does take him a third team. I think I need to make a trade, either to make this team better or just get Zion off this team. I was about to get the hiccups right there. So we're the 18. I don't know why there's no play-in tournament. Oh, I guess when I changed it to the record in the conference, 1-8. Yeah, that's what eliminated the play-in tournament. All right, whatever. There's no play-in tournament. So Ingram, he's got an injury, really. But him, George, and Zion all kind of balled out this year. It's a nice big three they do have going. Walker Kessler is now the center. Looks like they picked him up, signed him. Can they pull off the upset over the Phoenix Suns, who have Caleb Houston, a former MVP? They have more MVPs than we do. So let's see what is going on with my controller. All right, let's simulate the round. Do they pull off the upset? 2-1, 3. Oh my God, they actually do. They were down, 3-1? It was, 3-1. And they blow it. Oh, nice. So now we got San Antonio. Can they beat them and go to the conference finals? Or was that all for nothing? Yes, they beat them in 7. Wow. Would you look at that? Owen Wilson type. Okay, can Zion carry this team? This would be great for his legacy, winning it as an 8 seed. Can they beat the Timberwolves? Yes, they win this in 7. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. All right, now they got the Cavs in the finals, who have Sheldon Young, Garland, Pinkero. Yeah, that's a filthy, 2-3-4. I do want to take a look how many years ago it was from when the Cavs beat the Pelicans in the finals. So it was just 3 years ago. Can they get revenge? Who's going to win this NBA Finals? And it is the Pelicans in 6. Zion carries as an 8th seed. Wow, that's good for your legacy. His third Finals MVP award at age 28. Wow. That's really good. All right, one thing I did want to check was where Zion maybe stands in some of these records, like all-time points. A couple season-ending injuries will hurt, and I haven't seen his name yet. Is he not in the top 100? Oh, yeah. I mean, no shot he's close to here. Okay, so we got to keep going a little bit. I mean, I don't know, though. I really thought, I saw Trae Young there. Surprise, maybe Zion was there and I just completely missed him. So we'll check again next offseason. So I will not be trading Zion because they just won it all. So that would be kind of silly to do that. So we'll take a look at who they ended up drafting here in the, 2029 NBA draft. They got Rudolph Irving. Guess that would be Kyrie's son. And we'll see if they pick up anybody here in free agency. We'll take a look. And they get Aaron Gordon. All right, Aaron Gordon is 33? They pick up Patrick Baldwin, a former 11th overall pick. Hasn't really panned out too much in the league, but I do like those signings. Monty Morris as well. Player progression, Zion regresses? What? All right, well, he's in the final year of his contract. We'll see what happens throughout the season, if they get one done with him or if he ends up being a free agent. But it is what it is. I mean, they just won a championship, so they could still do that. So I don't think they're in any dry spell right now where I would have to step in. I was very shocked they went as an 8 seed with 3 7-game series in a row. So Keyonte George has been moved to the bench. They got Sebastian Jeffries. Trey Jones is the starting point guard. Still have Zion and Ingram. Patrick Baldwin down there as well. Have Kenneth McGetty. Have Kevin Moore still. And we'll see how they do here in the 2029-2030 season. All right, I'm about to step in. Now, Brandon Ingram has been very good throughout his Pelicans tenure, and he has been good this year. But Zion Williamson has yet to play with a really good point guard throughout his career, and with a lot of good wings like Ingram and Keyonte George, who's currently hurt, and that's why they're the 10th seed. I think I'm going to move Brandon Ingram, because Zion Williamson just signed a 3-year extension with the Pelicans, so he's going to be here for a while, and I would like them to, have a point guard that's going to be able to facilitate for Zion for the years to come. And a 25-year-old Ausar Thompson, I think, is the answer. Brandon Ingram for Ausar Thompson, let's get it done. That's probably the big move I'm going to make stepping in, and I'm hoping that gets them back into one of the elite teams in the Western Conference, because this 10th seed shit just isn't going to cut it out if we want Zion to become the GOAT. And just like that, we are the 6th seed as LaMelo Ball takes home the MVP award. Zion wasn't top 8 in scoring, it looks like. Damn, Zion was a little bit low this year, 21st. Okay. I don't really care, though. Maybe it's the Finals MVPs that makes Zion the GOAT. He doesn't care about those regular season awards because he turns it up when it comes to the playoffs after he's All-NBA third team. We are the sixth seed as the playoff rotation is going to be Thompson, George, Baldwin, Zion, Şengün. Yeah, they signed up Alperen Şengün. They got Sam Vaughn off the bench, Kevin Moore, Trey Jones, Kenneth McGetty, and we already saw Zion's stats. So can they beat the Blazers, who recently won a championship in round one, pull off the upset 2-2, 3-2, and they beat them in six? The Pelican seeding really doesn't matter because they just prevail every year as the underdogs. So there's a really nice big three here, 29-year-old, 26-year-old, and 25-year-old. Can they beat the Minnesota Timberwolves and go to the conference finals? Oof. Nope, they cannot. They end up losing in six. So yeah, this Minnesota Timberwolves team, very good with Trevor Keels, Devin Booker. This dude, Arvidas Šenković, stud. Tyrone Jeffries, and who's going to end up winning it all? It is going to be the Clippers, and LaMelo Ball is your Finals MVP. So a bunch of big names retiring this year. Here's your Hall of Fame inductees, Anthony Davis and Kyrie Irving. AD gets his jersey tied by the Pelicans. I don't think that's going to happen in real life. And then do they do anything in free agency? We'll have to take a look. Brandon Clark looks like is gone. They signed Jamal Murray to a one-year contract. All right, that's somebody I didn't expect. He's a 77 overall. He's obviously way past his prime. They pick up Nasir Little and Tony Bradley. Shout out to the UNC Tar Heels. Pick up Luka Garza. And it looks like that is going to be it. So a fairly active free agency for the Pelicans. You know, it's nice to see that they're trying to get better. So they haven't really been making a lot of trades throughout this. And Keontae George regresses. He obviously had a big injury last year. All right, so let's take a look at the rotation for 2031. It's going to be Thompson, Jeffries, Baldwin, Williams, and Vaughn with Keontae George as the sixth man. This team should be able to win it all again, so let's see it. That's what I'm talking about, but no, the wrong Pelican won MVP. This is going to taint Zion's legacy. He's playing with too many MVPs. As for Short Thompson wins it, wow, what a trade by me stepping in. I really am the watcher, you know. Wow. He won MVP. Does Zion still get an All-NBA team, though? He gets All-NBA second team. All right, let's ride. So we are the finals favorites now with the MVP, Keontae George, Patrick Baldwin, and then obviously Zion Williamson, who posts up a career low, basically, in points per game at age 30, but still really good numbers, don't get me wrong. And before we hop into the playoffs, I do want to see where he's at in total points. Wow, Giannis is seventh all-time. Look at that. Okay, is this some joke? Zion has to be top. Wow, he's 73rd all-time. That seems very low, but it is what it is. All right, so let's just, you know, keep going here. Let's see if we can win it all and get maybe a fourth Finals MVP, or is it Short Thompson going to get it? But we have to win it first, and we are going to the Finals, and we lose in six. Oh, we'll never know who would have been Finals MVP. Damn, Zion is now 3-2 in his Finals career. They got Trey, RJ Barrett, and Jaylen Brown there. Damn, losing another finals hurts. I mean, he's been to five. It's really good. But if he doesn't finish top 10 all-time in scoring, that is going to hurt. I mean, do we get Zion off this team where he can go score elsewhere? I don't know. Because my job is to make him the GOAT, not to make him the Pelicans' GOAT, you know? So we'll see what they do. Do they bring back a Short Thompson? They better do that. They renounce the rights on him. Oh my God, are you guys actually not going to bring him back? Are you stupid? Oh my God, you signed Franz Wagner instead of the MVP? Oh, Jesus Christ. I might have to get Zion out of here next year. I mean, Zion does have a 1+1. He may opt out next year. We'll see. How much is that player option at? $0? Yeah, he's probably going to opt out. So, yeah, let's advance. We're getting Zion out of here. This is going to be his last year as the Pelican, opts in or not. I'm sorry, but if I trade for an MVP and you refuse to sign him, after being the one seed and losing in the finals, I don't know what to tell you. Yep, we're the 13th seed this year. Unfortunately, Zion did re-sign with the Pelicans. Stop doing that. It's not going anywhere. But I'm just going to use the way that he re-signed because he is loyal to them and said, trade me instead of me leaving so you get assets for me in return. So that is going to be the case. Just, you can't be the 13th seed with Zion. Injuries or not, this is unacceptable. K takes home MVP. I mean, if the Pistons offer me a deal for Zion, we are going to do that. Zion gets on. Let's see. No NBA teams. Did he get hurt this year? That is not going to help your all-time scoring if you did. I don't know. He looked fine. But yeah, the 13th seed, that is just not great at all. He ended up averaging 24 points, 10 rebounds, 4.5 assists. He played in 80 games this season, so he wasn't hurt. and the Detroit Pistons win it all with Cade Cunningham being your finals MVP. He had a hell of a season. So Joel Embiid ends up in the Hall of Fame. We end up with Jamie Peters there at 9 and Randall Miles there at 40. I didn't even know they had Matt Cleveland. Shout out to the Seminoles. So let's go here to free agency where we are going to trade Zion to the best possible team. Yeah. Like the Bulls. I mean, I'm going to go through each roster and see like who'd be the best fit for him. So he only has 3 offers. So I'm going to wait till free agency is done, then look at this again. And yeah, they didn't really do any big moves. You're a troll. They brought in Ausar Thompson's brother, Amen. I don't know if they're actually brothers, but like, that's basically what's going to annoy me. So we put up Zion in the trade finder. 1 offer, the Pacers, Dior Johnson. I mean, let's see. Are the Pacers good outside of Dior Johnson? They do have Chet Holmgren. They have Eduardo Garcia. I don't really know. Like, is that a good team? I don't know. So I found the team that I want Zion to go to. It is the Golden State Warriors, who has Monty Moreland, Vincent Iwachukwu. Yeah, I'm just going to call him VI. They'll have Jonathan Kuminga. I mean, could they maybe get this? Yeah, because they have 2 point guards there. So we're going to try to do Scoot Henderson. And then I'm going to also ask for 1, 2, 3 first-round picks. And they say no. 2 first-round picks, no. Are you kidding me? Yeah, sure. Whatever. We're doing that. All right, let's go over to the Golden State Warriors now. That is the team we are going to be controlling. And I think this is good enough for Zion's legacy where he can maybe win multiple more championships. So if we take a look at the rotation, it is Monty Moreland, it is Dylan Sharp, Jonathan Kuminga, Zion, and VI. That is a very good starting 5. It's a very respectable bench, but still not great. Steve Kerr is the head coach. That's a plus. All right, so we're good to go, and we'll see how Zion does with his new team. So the Warriors end up as the 3 seed. Cade Cunningham wins MVP in Sacramento. Okay, of all teams. Does Zion reclaim an All-NBA spot? Kuminga does. Okay. Zion is on All-NBA 13, posted career low in points, rebounds, but a career high in assists. So we'll take a look at the rotation here. This team should win it all. It is really good, and I'm hoping that is the case. So let's see what happens. The first playoff run for Zion and the Warriors. They have the Minnesota Timberwolves in round 1, which could end in a defeat, but no, they beat them. They beat Dallas. Come on, beat Cade. Cade and the Kings look like they're the team to beat now. After the Wizards beat them in the finals. Sadiq Bey. Shout out to the former Pistons here. Cade and Bey in the finals. He wins finals MVP. Damn, that Kings team beat us. We got a rivalry here in the Pacific Division. So Zion, not sniffing retirement at the moment. Jokic heads to the Hall. Jaylen Brown and Mitchell get their jerseys retired. They want to change this back to 3 seconds. Okay, so that's fine with me. All right, so do they make any plays in free agency? They bring back Vincent, which is nice to see that they're actually going to bring back their stars, unlike Ausar Thompson in New Orleans. They also signed OG Anunoby, Prince Ogbi. Pretty cool. I'll take it. And player progression, Zion. Oh, he got a spinal injury in the playoffs, man. Zion may retire early because of injury. He's had a torn patella, torn Achilles, spinal injury in this video. Not great. And he's going to start off the season hurt. Sheesh. All right, so this is the 2034 season. This is also Zion's, what is, 15th year in the league, age 34. Let's see what happens. All right, so we're finishing up the 2034 season. The Warriors are fighting for the 2nd or the 3rd seed in the Western Conference. It's looking like it's going to end up being the 3rd seed. And yes, it is, as Victor Wembanyama wins MVP for the New York Knicks. Steve Kerr does get Coach of the Year, though, which, all right, I'll take that. Does Zion get an All-NBA team? I still hate how this glitch from, like, 2K18 is still in the game. Like, you just saw that. If I, like, go in straight off the season, All-NBA first team, and I press RT, it'll take me to, like, all defensive first team. Don't know why it does that. Yeah, no Zion for the first time in a while now. He didn't play the whole year because he got hurt. He's now an 87 overall at the age of 33. I do want to take a look at some of his records, like, total points. Has he cracked the top 50? Like, Anthony Edwards is 20th. How is Zion not up here? I don't know. Wow, Zion's not even in the top 50? Ingram's, he's missed that much time. Wow. Where is Zion? Wait, I must have missed him, right? No way he's behind RJ Barrett. Okay, so I did pass him. He was top 50. He was 40. He's 45 all time. That's going to be tough. He really needed the rings to go with it, but he's only got 3. Can he maybe get 4 this playoff run? Let's see. They end up beating the Rockets in 5. They beat the Kings, but can they beat the Blazers? They can, and they beat the Raptors. Let's go. Zion is now 4-2 in the finals. Does he get finals MVP? He does not, though. That goes to Monty Moreland. So Zion now has 4 championships under his belt, which is very impressive. 4-2 in the finals. There goes Giannis. Wow, Paolo Banchero retired after just 7 seasons. That is pretty shocking to me. Donnie Mack, though, they're going to extend him a qualifying offer. And then let's just take a look at moratorium here. Do they have any big free agents? Zion is a free agent. Okay. Is he going back to the Warriors? It looks like he will go back to the Warriors. He does have a 2-year, $50 million deal waiting from them. Is he going to go back there? I think so. Yeah, he's going to go back to the Warriors. He does. 2 years, $50 million. It would have been interesting to see if Zion goes to a third team, because that I would let him do, because I interfered already trading for an MVP and trading Zion to Golden State. It did get him another championship, which is nice. There's Scoota Henderson. How was he in New Orleans? Really good, too. So it worked out, but they didn't have really much team success with him. And day 12 has passed. They have Moreland, VI. Zion is now down to an 84 overall. So obviously his best days are behind him. So it's going to be tough for him to end up as the GOAT. Like Giannis's career for how we've done these is definitely number one, I would say, with Zion being 2. Maybe we'll keep tracking. They're moving Zion to the bench. All right, I'm not going to interfere with that. Warriors end up as the 3 seed. Does Zion take home Sixth Man of the Year? No, that goes to Hugh Meeks. All right, he was really good. Obviously, Zion's probably not going to get an All-NBA team honors because he came off the bench this year. Is that still going to be true for the playoffs? No, he is starting now. They've decided to roll this out there. Alperen Şengün loves playing with Zion, it seems like. So let's see what his stats looked like from this past season. About 14 points, 7 rebounds, 5 assists. All right. Career high 3-point percentage. Can he get another ring under his belt? They're down 2-0 to the Rockets, and they end up losing in 5. So Zion is still 4-2 in his all-time career in the finals. He's only been a 6, which is a lot, And he is still here with us. He has not retired or died. Cat gets his jersey retired by the Raptors and the Timberwolves. Damn, we played with the Raptors for a while. We will approve of these. All right, so let's see what they do in free agency. Do they let Monty Moreland and Vincent walk? No way. That would be silly. They bring back Moreland, but not Vincent. That's a little stupid. They bring in Devin Vassell. Okay, I don't know why you would do that. Is Zion still here? Yeah, he signed a 2-year deal worth, I think, like $50 million last year. All right, play progression. Zion is now down to an 81 overall. Simulate this season here. We are in the year. I was going to say, where is Zion? But he's currently starting off the year hurt. 2036. Let's see what happens. All right, so we're getting to the point where, like, this wasn't for Giannis. Because, like, at the end of Giannis's career, he was still starting, competing. Zion is 35 years old. He's 82. He's about to be a free agent. His team was just a 13th seed. This could be his last year. We could see him retire right now, and I think we will. But let's find out just in case, like, obviously. And then if not, then we'll see where he goes at the end of the season. I will not, you know what, stop him from retiring. I saw Tom Simmons Finals MVP. You should have kept him, New Orleans. You could have had another dynasty there. Ingram retires. Didn't he retire? I don't know. But it looks like Zion does not retire. Wow. Unless he's down here somewhere, but I don't think he is. Yeah, Zion is still going. Oh, no, I'm blind. He retired. How did I miss that? That's the second time in this video I've missed him. So Zion calls it quits after 16 years at age 35. So let me override him now just to, like, look at his player card, anything of that. So this is how his career ended up. I think if we were going to rank our 2 GOAT race series players, I think Giannis had the better career. Zion would be number 2. And then whoever we do next will be ranked between those guys. His career in Golden State wasn't great, but it did get him a championship. Nonetheless, it did. We take a look at his awards. He was a 13-time All-Star, 4-time NBA champion, 3-time All-NBA first team, 2-time All-NBA second team, 3-time All-NBA third team, and then also first team All-Rookie once, because we know Ja won Finals MVP, geez, Rookie of the Year that year. He ends his career with no MVPs, which is going to be tough to be calling you the GOAT. I don't really think we can. In points scored all time, Zion is 34th. It's all right. Field goals made. He's actually 15th all time in field goals made. Yeah, because he had to get a lot of those points without shooting threes. That's probably why he didn't get higher than I thought, because the 3 points made were just not there. He was 47th all time in total rebounds. In points per game, he had 22.5 all time. which would have put him tied with Bernard King for 26th all time. That's actually pretty good. Now, I have a feeling his field goal percentage is going to be one of the best of all time. No, maybe not. I don't know. I guess his later years hurt a lot. See, you're seeing like Tony Bradley's like 20th all time. Maybe not. Maybe I was way too bullish on Zion because I don't even see him. Might have passed him, but damn, never mind. So yeah, I would not consider Zion as the GOAT. I think Giannis had a way better case. Let me know what you guys think of Zion. Is he a top 10 player of all time with these accolades? Let me know down below. Also, let me know down below who we should do next. I know I'm going to get a lot of quests for LaMelo Ball, Cade Cunningham, Luka Doncic, Jason Tatum. Let me know down below. Drop a like if you guys did enjoy, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.